Looks like the announcement for the Switch Pro is going to be happening on Thursday. So what's going on here? Well, apparently the co-founder of Xbox Era, who goes by the name of Special Ed, I think his actual name is Nick, tweeted over on Twitter that he's been hearing that there's a Direct planned, or Mini Direct, for the Nintendo Switch Pro. At least that's the rumored name, that's what people call it. He calls it the Super Nintendo Switch. That's just the name that he wants it to be, which is kind of funny. We don't know actual official name of it or, you know, anything like that. People just call it Switch Pro. So apparently on Thursday this week, there will be an official Direct prior to E3 talking and detailing what's going on with the Switch Pro and when it's coming out and all that good stuff. What do I think about this? Is this a reliable source? Well, this guy is verified, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. I personally haven't been keeping track on him of what he said in the past or what came to fruition and what didn't. My job is to report on what I'm hearing and what's going on the interwebs when it comes to the gaming industry, and this is kind of what I'm doing. So, do I think this is feasible? Yes, simply because Jason Schreier said last week that the original announcement was going to happen Friday, but it got pushed. He didn't say it will happen on Friday, he said it might happen on Friday. Nick also said it has been pushed before, but as of today, it is scheduled for Thursday. Today is Tuesday, so we're looking at 2 more days here, or, you know, less than 48 hours, I guess you could say. So we will find out if it's true or if it's been pushed over again. But if we're hearing two things already that are similar from two different reliable sources, then I would argue that this is indeed real. But again, take it with a grain of salt. Rumors are rumors after all until they happen. Either way, really interesting tidbit. So that's what's going on, Nintendo fans. Just keep your eyes peeled for Thursday. We're gonna keep track and make sure that hopefully, if it does happen, we're gonna cover and write something about it. With that being said, thank you guys so much, and we're gonna move on to the next thing. Dear PlayStation fans, do you guys miss PlayStation Experience? Because I sure do. So, apparently, this is a rumor from 4chan, so take it with a massive, absolutely massive grain of salt. What's going on here? On June 28th, there's gonna be a PlayStation Experience, according to 4chan rumors. Not a very reliable place, but there are sometimes true things on it, but most of the time, 80%, I would say it's fake. Anyway, on with the story. So it's going to be a PlayStation event, which is basically Sony's E3 version. You know, they're not doing E3 anymore, they do their own events. And they're going to be holding basically an event for titles including 2021 and 2022 releases, such as God of War Ragnarok, Horizon Forbidden West, and of course, plenty of other surprises. So, apparently we're also going to get our first look at PSVR 2. We know that PSVR 2 is real because they showed off, I think they showed off controllers for it, and they've talked about it briefly in a PlayStation blog back in February or March, if I'm not mistaken. We will link the link to the article in the description down below, so you guys can check out this article fully to see all the details. And apparently Horizon Forbidden West is going to have a release date on there as well in that event, and it's November 30th, which is obviously holiday this season, which will be fantastic for Sony to have their first big PS5 title out the door. Well, I mean, Ratchet & Clank is coming up here in a week or so that's, you know, a pretty big title as well, but not as big as Horizon Forbidden West for the obvious reasons. So what do I think about this? Do I think this is true? I mean, it's plausible. I don't think it's too far-fetched, but it's also kind of too good to be true in a way. Either way, man, I'm hoping that there will be something. I'm assuming that Sony will do some sort of a summer event at some point. They have to show their stuff, right, for the rest of this year and what's going on beyond. They can't just be sitting there. Is it going to be on June 28th? I don't know. Is this real? I don't know. I don't know anything. I'm not confirming or denying. I'm just saying what is being said on the internet, so please don't take my words for, you know, verbatim or anything like that I said this and that. Just take it with a massive grain of salt. This is 4chan stuff. Either way, if this is real, this is very exciting. Square Enix is going to be there, apparently. Ubisoft and EA as well, and Square Enix is going to be showing off a remake of a project that they've been working on along with Bluepoint. So who knows? Hopefully this is real stuff. With that being said, guys, thank you so much for checking that out, and we're moving on to the next thing. Battlefield fans rejoice, because finally on June 9th at 10 a.m. EST, 7 a.m. PST, we will finally be getting our first look at the next Battlefield game. It has been a long time coming. This is the first Battlefield game that we're getting on next-gen consoles, and unfortunately I think it is going to be cross-gen, but from what we heard, there's two different teams working on this game, one specifically for old gen and one specifically for next gen or current gen now, which is fantastic. So we will be getting a dedicated game that is meant to be played on new generation consoles at its best capacity, hopefully, and just see how it goes. You know, the game is gonna have 128 players from the rumors that we've heard. It's gonna have amazing, you know, physics and a lot of destruction that we haven't seen in any other Battlefield games previously, and it's set in the near future, like 2030s, and it's gonna have like robot dogs and jets and a lot of cool crazy things like droids and stuff. So hopefully the trailer will show us some of those things. I don't know if it's gonna be a just a regular glorified Battlefield trailer like always, and then the gameplay reveal later at a conference or something, but who knows. You know, we will finally see it on June 9th. I'm just expecting like a as usual EA's glorified, you know, gameplay trailer like they did for Battlefield 1 and 5 or whatever, and the actual gameplay I think is probably going to be at Microsoft conference. That's usually where they like to show Battlefield, unless Sony has rights to it, but I highly doubt it, because we've been hearing that this holiday season a big FPS game is going to be on Game Pass day one, and I have a feeling it's going to be Battlefield. It just makes too much sense because EA Play is part of Game Pass now. It's just going to be a great game to have for holiday season if you're getting an Xbox Series X, and you don't have to shell out 70 or 60 bucks for it. Absolutely phenomenal. Definitely looking forward to it, to see what both Call of Duty and Battlefield will be offering to people this year. It's definitely an exciting time. I can feel the E3 energy today. It's getting close, and I cannot wait to see this game, and I hope you as well. Let us know in the comments below what you're looking forward to in Battlefield 6 or whatever it's going to be called, and what your hopes and worries are. And with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching this daily news bit. Make sure to like and subscribe, turn on those notifications, and I will see you soon as tomorrow. Peace!